I believe that God is going to work a miracle in your life by the end of this song. No matter what situation you find yourself in right now, just know that all you have to do is believe in the name of Jesus, my brother and my sister. Listen.
Welcome to our prayer meeting this morning. For those who are tuning in live, we welcome you and we just thank God that you're able to tune in with us, with our church family. Thank you for being with us this morning. Amen. And before we go into our worship and our praise, just a reading from the Word of God, and it's found in the book of Psalms 121, and it says, I look up to the mountains. Does my help come from there? My help comes from the Lord, who made the heavens and the earth. He will not let you stumble and fall. The one who watches over you will not sleep. Indeed, he who watches over Israel never tires and never sleeps. The Lord himself watches over you. The Lord stands beside you as your protective shade. The sun will not hurt you by day, nor the moon at night. The Lord keeps you from all evil and preserves your life. The Lord keeps watch over you as you come and go, both now and forever. When I read this psalm and when I hear it in music, it just encourages me and it reminds me of the great God that we serve, especially during these times, this corona pandemic and everything that's going on with the uncertainty of what's going on in this world. It's good to know that we have a God. We know that this God that created us, who created heaven and earth, this God will never let us stumble and fall. Can you say amen? The one that watches over you and he does not sleep. He never tires and he never sleeps. He watches over you and he stands beside you as your protective shade. When I think of that, I'm thinking of right now it's the summertime and it's very hot. And a lot of times we need that shade to cool us down and it protects us from the elements, the heat from the sun. And when I think about that, I think about that God that we serve, the God, our creator. He protects us, he keeps us, even through these times. So if you're discouraged or you're uncertain about the times right now, what's going on with the jobs and finances and this virus, just be encouraged that we serve a God that will protect us. He says he will keep you from all evil and he will preserve your life. And I stand on that promise that he's made for me. And he says he watches over you when you come and go, both now and forever. So be encouraged from the word of God this morning. Let us pray as we begin our worship service and go into our worship. Father God, we just thank you, Lord. We praise you, we glorify you. Father, for you're worthy of praise. We thank you for this day that was not promised to us, but you woke us up this morning and you sent us here, Lord. And so we just thank you and praise you for that. Father, as we prepare to give you worship and honor that you deserve, and as we prepare to go into our prayer meeting, Father God, we pray that your Holy Spirit just bless us. We pray that you be with us, be in our midst this morning, Father God. Those who are tuning in live, we pray, Father God, that your Holy Spirit just be with them and help them, Lord, as we prepare to worship and give you all glory and praise that you deserve. We love you, we thank you, we praise you.
To us alone, may all our I will bow down and worship you.
That you remember Pastor David and Tina Lisa. Remember them in your prayers. That God continue to bless them and lead them during this time. Also ask that you remember all of our Tamama Tina Matsua, Tinaya Tsivale, Tinaya Malolo Yalamatana, Tinaya Leai, Tinaya Fiabai, Tamamatsuya Tawala, and Joe. Let's remember all of those who have illnesses, who continue to need healing on their bodies, those who are going through dialysis, those who are going through cancer, those that are recovering from cancer who continue to need healing. Let's remember those in our prayer this morning. Let's remember those of our kids who are going to be getting ready to go back to school and just uncertain times right now. Just remember them in our prayers, as well as those who are supposed to go and start off in college. Remember them in prayer as well. Those who are already in college, who are getting ready to graduate, just remember AJ in Samoa and Brother Longvi'i in Utah, and Sam as he goes back in Arizona. Let's also remember those of our children who are in the military. Pray that God continue to protect them wherever their duty is or wherever they're stationed at, and that God continue to be with them. Let's also remember our President of the United States and his office. Just continue to pray that God continue to lead him as he continued to lead this country during this time. And then just whatever needs that you may have of individual, just go ahead and pray for those needs as well. And let's also remember the church as it's going through these difficult times of not getting to meet and gather like we're used to. Let's just pray that all of our church family and us as Christians just don't lose hope during this time, and that it's a good time that we're at home, that we can gather our families together, and that we can just encourage each other and pray with each other at home, and just to remind each other that during these times were meant to come, and it's just preparing us for the day that when Jesus is soon coming. So just prepare your hearts and prepare your families and just prepare yourselves during this time of the pandemic. And as we, as the worship team sings a song, we're going to go into prayer and just find a spot in your house, a place to just spend time with God this morning. In Jesus' name.
He is thank you.
we just praise you. We thank you, Lord, for being in our midst this morning. We thank you, Lord, for the breath of life that you've given us, Lord, another day that was promised us. But you woke us up this morning and you set us on our way. We thank you, Lord. We praise you. We glorify you, Father, for you are worthy. You are worthy of praise. We thank you, Lord, that you continue to give us strength each and every day. We thank you, Lord, that you continue to provide for us our needs, our daily needs, food, clothing, and shelter, Father. Lord, we thank you for your protection upon each and every one of us, Lord, each and every day. Thank you for protecting us from sickness and from harm and danger that could come our way. You continue to lead and guide us and keep us safe, Father. Thank you for your grace and thank you for your mercy. Father God, we just come to you with our needs, Father, this morning. We just continue to lift up our Pastor David and Lisa. We pray, Father God, that you just continue to fill them, Lord, with your spirit, that your anointing just continue to fall upon them as they lead and guide our church. Father, we pray that you just continue to heal their bodies from any sickness, Lord, and just bless them with good health. We also remember all of our elderly folks, Lord, this morning, that you just continue to heal them, heal their bodies, Father God. Keep them far from any sickness and disease that may come to them, Father God. Strengthen them, Lord, in their years, Father. And we also remember our youth who are in school right now, Father God, and who are getting ready to go back into school, and those who are in college. Father, we just pray that you continue to sustain them and keep them, Father God, as they continue on with another year, Father. We just pray that you just continue to help them and lead them in those who are going through their final years of schooling and those who are preparing to start school. We pray, Father, that your hand of mercy and grace be upon them as well. We pray, Father God, for our church family who are going through sickness, who have illnesses, Father God. We pray, Lord, in the name of Jesus, that you touch them wherever they're at right now, Father God. We pray that you touch them and heal them, Father God. Those who are going through dialysis or awaiting kidney transplants, Father, we pray that we know that a kidney is on the way, and we pray, Father, that you just sustain each and every one of them until that time comes, Father. Continue to heal their bodies and strengthen them. Those who are going through cancer treatments and those who are recovering from cancer, Father, we just pray that you continue to touch them, Father God, in the name of Jesus, right now where they're at. We pray, Father, Lord, that your healing just take place and that you just heal their bodies, Lord, and just touch them, Father God. Renew them, give them strength and restore, Lord, the strength that they need this morning, Father. We also remember our church family, Lord, as we're not meeting as often as we would like, Father God, but we just pray, Lord, that you just sustain and keep each and every one of our church family, Father God, that you just continue to move in them, that your Holy Spirit encourage them, Father God, to get together with their families at this time and to just encourage each other through your word, Father God, and prepare each and every one of us, Father, for that time that you will come back to take your children home. We ask, Lord, that you just help us, Lord, to prepare ourselves individually, Lord. Help us to live our lives right and to prepare, Father God, through your word, our lives for your coming return. I pray, Father God, that you be with our President of the United States and his staff, Lord, as he continues to lead this country. Pray that you protect him and that you just continue to help him, Father God, as he leads this country, and just continue to be with him, Lord, and guide him and his staff, Father God. We ask that you just whatever individual needs that our church family may have this morning, Lord, I pray that you just meet them, Father God. And Father, I pray that you see us, Lord. You know our lives. We're not perfect people. And we ask, Father God, that if you see anything wrong in our lives, that we just that you forgive us, that you cleanse us from our sins and all of our unrighteousness. Lord, as your people prepare to start this day, we ask, Father God, that you lead and guide us, Lord, that you order our steps this morning. We pray, Father God, that your Holy Spirit just continue to fill us and help us, Lord, to do the things that we need to do for you this morning, Father God, in this day. We love you. We praise you, Father God. We thank you. We give you all glory and honor that you deserve, Father God. We ask that you bless your people today, Father, in everything that we do until we meet once again. We love you. We ask all of these things in your blessed name, Jesus. Amen. Thank you, church family, for tuning in and those who are tuning in with us. God bless your day today. We love you. Hope to see you again soon.